Good day, I'm your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and I'm just here with a bit of an old, Imperious Impressions. This time it's of Legend of Grimrock 2 on that there PC. Right, for those of you who don't know, Legend of Grimrock is a, oh sweet buttery Christ, look at that, oh dear. Yes, Legend of Grimrock is a, Legend of Grimrock 2 is the sequel to Legend of Grimrock. Okay, that's something I haven't seen before. But it's the sequel. Are there leprechauns in this game now? But it's the sequel to Legend of Grimrock 1. Legend of Grimrock 1 being a turn-based, first-person, grid-based RPG of sorts. If you want to see how much I've played of it, you can actually see right there on my pre-release thing there. You see 45 minutes on my character's level 3, except I think for my lizard man. I think my lizard man's still level 2, which is upsetting, because I have a sword that I want him to use that he can't. Legend of Grimrock was... Oh dear, it's a rat man. Fuck off, you prick. But yeah, Legend of Grimrock... As I say, it was a turn-based, dungeon-crawling RPG. Very much meant to evoke the kind of older... games of that style. In Legend of Grimrock 1, you played a group of 4 prisoners chained together at the ankles and thrown into the titular Mount Grimrock, and given basically the task of either you die in here or you survive and live to fight another day, and if you get out, you're free. In Legend of Grimrock 2, the opening is that you are shipwrecked on the Isle of Nex. You're still prisoners, though it says not about whether or not you're chained to the ankle, so there goes the explanation for why you're all inexplicably pressed really close together. Ooh, Philosopher's Stone. Nice. But yeah, as in fact my description suggests, Legend of Grimrock 2 doesn't actually take place in a dungeon, although we are currently in one. No, Legend of Grimrock 2 takes place on the Isle of Nex, meaning that essentially you have a hell of a lot more variety when it comes to exactly what kind of places and enemies you will be fighting, rather than being stuck in the one dungeon. You have various different kinds of environments, though frankly there do appear to be a lot of your standard Legend of Grimrock 1 style dungeons left and right. A couple of the new additions I'll go through right now. First of all, as you may be able to tell here, firearms. Also, I'm not certain, but I think Alchemist might actually be a new class. I think Farmer is one that they've added, which is a class that's not particularly good at anything and doesn't get experience from combat, but rather it gets its experience from fighting. I also kind of think that maybe Rattling is a new race. I don't remember Rattlings, if they were in Legend of Grimrock 1, so I think that's a new race. I'm imagining... No? Sorry, this is new. My, this is new. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, I'll just go look through the rest of the dungeon. But yeah, so it's the sequel to Legend of Grimrock 1. Basically, that's all. That was the point. Developed by, I believe the dev team is Almost Human Games. Fuck me. I'm really starting to hate the rattling enemies, I swear to God. Oh fuck, one was behind me as well. Uppity pr- At least this one can't throw anything at me. Makes them easier to deal with. If they can't throw shit at me, they're easier to kill. Actually, 2 or 1 stone, that. Fuck off. Yeah. For those of you who don't know, I was actually really very keen on the original Legend of Grimrock. I genuinely thought it was, I think I'd be willing to go so far as to say that the year it came out, that was probably, if not my favorite game, it was probably up there. Even though I honestly have never played, you know, the kind of, the specific genre of game that it was attempting to ape. That wasn't really something that I grew up playing. I still deeply enjoyed it. So when I managed to get review code for you know, the sequel, I was quite pleased. Oh dear, Drusilla's leveled up. Let's get her light weapons there and hope that she doesn't die. Can I get a fire? I want this thing dead. Okay, good. That's good. So can we equip our fine rip yard? Oh, and we've got dual wielding. What the fuck is dual wielding? Damage, a third level, you can dual wield light weapons, fifth level you can dual wield light weapons. Cool. Good to know. Good. Yeah. But yes, no, sorry, Legend of Grimrock 2. Right, okay, so I have been enjoying it thus far. I do have a few complaints at the moment. One of them being, I'm not sure if it's how well this is going, how, like, clear this is going to be when you're watching the video, but the frame rate isn't grand. And you know what? The frame rate isn't that big a problem where, given, you know, the nature of this game. By the way, it's going to freeze for a second while I use that. There it is. But yeah, the frame rate, given the nature of this game is kind of this kind of pseudo turn-based grid-based gameplay, it's not too big a problem. It is, however, noticeable, and to the point at which I remember remarking of... I must have been in here and forgotten what the hell was in here. But yes, I remember... I'll actually get out of this dungeon and go keep exploring the aisle. But I remember remarking of Legend of Grimrock 1 when I played it originally that I was surprised... Okay, no, I can't go back out. I do just need to find the exit. But that I was surprised at how well it ran and how good it looked. That... I can't extend that praise to this game. It looks... generally, the dungeons at the very least, because, I don't really have a... You fucking... because I don't really have a frame for comparison with, the exterior. But in terms of the actual dungeons, the game looks about as... God damn it, he's dead again. The game looks about as good as Legend of Grimrock 1. But it runs considerably worse. You know, right now I'm recording, I'm clocking around 20, maybe 25, like, around there, frames per second. It's got a couple of other issues. Number one, the menus are really fucking odd. Like, there's a bizarre... The fucking... Get back here, you fucking uppity shit. You... Fucking running away from me. But yeah, the menus are bizarre. Like, there's a bizarre kind of delay in the menus. Like, okay, I'll tell you exactly when I press the escape and you'll see what I mean. I'm pressing escape to go to the pause menu. I've pressed it now. You see, there's like a fraction of a second delay that's very odd. That's not connected to the frame rate. That's just the game. V-Sync is basically pointless in this game because... Yeah, without V-Sync, I suffer from, you know, better frame rates, but some extreme screen tearing. Right now, I've got on the triple buffering setting, which, kind of gets rid of the, V-Sync problem, and oh my god, my entire group's gonna die, because I can't focus on combat while I'm talking. But yeah, the triple buffering does get rid of most of the screen tearing problem. However, at the same time, it introduces a problem all its own. Fucking Vans. In that... the triple buffering is the only one that really works. It doesn't get... it does seem to get rid of the problem. The actual just V-Sync option itself, as opposed to the specific, triple buffering setting, is fucking pointless. There is absolutely no reason to use that setting. Because, yeah, does it get rid of the, does it get rid of the screen tearing? Yeah, it does get rid of the screen tearing, but what does it do as well? It eats the frame rate. It strangles the fucker, and we just got a game over. But yeah, it genuinely does absolutely strangle the fucker if you switch on the V-Sync, which is a bit of a pisser. Another problem I have with the game is one that's a bit more conceptual. It's more of a problem with the way the game is presented than a problem with the game itself. Let's load back in here. And that problem is that... There's an odd disconnect I'm having with the way that the game moves and the way that the game is presented. It's kind of difficult to show that right now. I really should have figured out... I probably should have started recording from the exterior. In fact, you know what? I won't go back to my save. I am going to go back to the main menu and I'm going to jump into a new save to show you the exteriors in the game. But yeah, that my main problem is literally just a problem with the fact that in the first game, the movement system made sense. I will not create my characters. I will get a bunch of randomly generated characters. But the movement system made sense in the first game due to the aforementioned that they are chained together at the foot, and the fact that the game was like entirely took place in interior, very regular, tiled areas. Whereas in this game, the vast majority of it takes place in this kind of outdoors overworld. Oh my god, the frame rate is fucking tanking out here. Oh sweet Jesus, no. Oh, wait, I need to pick that up now. There we go. Yeah, the frame rate's tanking out here. Oh good god. Oh my god. But yeah, like, you can actually just see it here. You know, there's no definite boundaries, visual boundaries, to where every spot begins and ends. So that can cause a couple of issues when you're trying to pick up objects, just because it's not exactly clear, you know, how far away the object is because of the lack of definite boundaries. And the fact that it just kind of makes the movement system feel a bit odd. I had never noticed that that was a face before. But it makes the movement system feel a bit more odd and stilted than it otherwise would. If you understand. Oh, fuck me, his name's Astaroth. What isn't he giving us? Shadow, Mulrag, Fang. Yep. Actually, you know what? Given, you know, I am actually going to mention the frame rate issues again here, because it's only just occurring to me now that these frame rate issues are actually worse than I first thought, because it's only occurred to me now that the game is actually a hell of a lot more reliant on reactions than you might have expected, because obviously almost all of this game's combat is just kind of dodging around the enemies in this grid. Don't you fucking waddle away from me, young man. Uppity prick. Oh, no. But yeah, just there's a lack of visual. There's a lack of kind of visual shorthand when it comes to the movement system, because it's gone from taking place exclusively in these very overtly visually tiled areas to taking place in these open outdoors areas for most of the game. Other than what I've mentioned before, it seems to primarily play, but ooh, darts. Shame we don't really seem to have, is there like a dart gun around here? Like, how do I, are these ammunition? Or are these throwing weapons? Oh, those are throwing weapons. Okay. Has that kind of hit an invisible wall? Yes, it has. Yes, because despite being outdoors, it still behaves. Yeah, that's another thing. Despite being outdoors, the game does still behave as if it's in a dungeon when you're not. That's because it's obviously kind of mostly built on the same engine as Legend of Grimrock, just a less well-optimized one. And there's another thing. You know, some of this stuff, like the optimization, may be improved by the time the game is fully released, because bear in mind that I am playing a pre-release build of the game at the moment, and one that is being patched seemingly every other fucking day. Like, I can't actually think of a day that's gone by since I've gotten my copy of this game that I haven't had to download a patch for it. So that hopefully these optimization problems will be gone by the time the full game comes out, but at the moment, it has, you know, too many optimization issues for me to say it's an improvement. Really. You know, it plays like Grimrock. It looks like Grimrock. If you like Legend of Grimrock and just want more Grimrock, you know, I will wholeheartedly recommend this game. If you've played the first game, if you're already a fan of the series, pick this game up. However, if you want kind of a dungeon crawling RPG and you haven't played the original, I would recommend the original over this, just because the original makes more sense. It doesn't have as much of a variety from what I've seen, but the original's the original visuals makes more sense with the gameplay. It's a hell of a lot more definite. It's a hell of a lot more definite. It's a hell of a lot more well optimized. And generally, just from what I've played thus far, I did prefer the original. But again, bear in mind, this is a first impression. As I've said, I've only played it for about an hour every kind of include my completely botched first attempt at playing this game. Just grab these knives here. But yeah, if you already like Legend of Grimrock, buy Legend of Grimrock 2 if you can, because it is basically more of what you already, you know, more of what you already know you like. If you're not sure about it, I'd suggest picking up Legend of Grimrock 1 first instead of just leaping into Legend of Grimrock 2. Also, I believe, I haven't been able to prove this because I don't actually have Legend of Grimrock installed on my PC at the moment, but I think you can actually import your team from Legend of Grimrock 1. One can only hope. It seems that way because you can import characters, as far as I can tell. You can import characters from this game, and they, you know, almost all of the game, even down to the portraits, appear to be from Legend of Grimrock 1. I think I've really said my piece there. I'm gonna play more of this later on, hopefully after it's had a couple of patches to kind of stabilize it, just to get rid of that, the really awkward thing. It just at the moment appears to be a less well-optimized, less well-polished version of Legend of Grimrock with a bit more content because of the greater variety, the fact that it's not stuck in one dungeon affords it. That's it. That's my review. A less well-optimized, less well-polished version of Legend of Grimrock that I can only really fully recommend to people who have already played and enjoyed Legend of Grimrock 1. One thing I will say, fighting these kind of fairly well-detailed tortoises is a hell of a lot of a better introduction to the combat system of Legend of Grimrock than fighting the snails that Legend of Grimrock 1 had as the first enemy, because they look more intimidating and they actually have a quirk to them that kind of helps you figure out, yeah, you're going to have to figure out how to work within the Legend of Grimrock kind of slightly odd grid-based, real-time grid-based version of combat. But, yeah, that's my review. As ever, there will be a link to the Steam store page for the game in the description below, and that's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your Humble Bear Cyber Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. So, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Let's be honest, I'm not kidding anyone, I don't know if I enjoyed it, I'm a pre-recorded message. Regardless, if you did enjoy it, please like the video, subscribe to my channel, and leave a comment below. I do read every comment I get. I need some form of validation for spending as much time as I do making these fucking things. If you want to see more of my stuff, please have a look around my channel. I've been making videos for years now, so there is a lot of content to see. I also try to upload once a day, 5 days a week, often with some side stuff going on over the weekend, so you may want to check that out. If you wish, you can follow me on Twitter, where I've been known to post inane bullshit on a semi-regular basis, and if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always subscribe to my Patreon campaign. Every subscriber on there brings me closer to not having to get off my fat ass and get a real job. And I'll eventually be able to upgrade my PC and all that shit. Well, that's it for this pre-recording. Hope to see you all in the next video. Now, get the fuck out. This one's over. Leave. Now.